So we are back again, and I'm Anuradha Mittal. We are in discussion with Dharmesh Mehta ji, and in Delhi. Sir, ek word mein bataiye, what is Rahu?
It's already given 1.5 hours.
I know, but agar ek bar ek concise form mein kisi ko bolna hoga ki Rahu is this, because sab logon ko itna dar lagta hai. Is there a positive connotation to Rahu?
Yes, see, I believe as all planet I have given name, Rahu is a booster. So booster means you have something and Rahu just come and boost it. Like in a child, no, when they are under one age, you have to give all polio and all doses. After 5 years, when they complete 5 years, you have to give booster dose. Because that medicine, if keep alive in the body, it has to be again reworked. So Rahu is a work which you have already done in past birth. If some deeds has left out, so Rahu will come in Dasha or Gochar and it will boost your things. See, when we have done the UT, we already see that Rahu is a booster. It has absorbed the energy of the planet and give the result. That was the indication about this, that Rahu is a booster.
Yeah. So sir, ab hamara two topics have been left. One is Dasha and one is Transit, sir. So should we start with Dasha first?
Yeah, that's a small chapter, and many people get very much scared when that Rahu Dasha start. When my first video about Ketu is published, no, people say, what happened to the Rahu Dasha? I give them very small things. See, Rahu Dasha, as we have discussed, is a booster. It depends on which stage it has come. See, we'll see the detail of Dasha in other videos, but in Dasha, the sequence run. First, second, third, fourth Dasha. It's a sequence. As like you have a Bhava, first house, second house, third house. Likewise, same as there is a Dasha also, birth Dasha, then second Dasha, third, fourth. So you make a broader part of even and odd. First, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Yeah, the odd Dasha. And 2, 4, 6, 8 is the even Dasha.
Correct.
Now if in your chart, if Rahu Dasha occurred, 2nd, 4th, 6th, 8 will be too far. So if it appears as a 2nd, 4th, and 6th Dasha, then you are lucky, Rahu will give you enough. So you don't have to scare if your Rahu Dasha, if you are born in the Mars Dasha, see my both the child have done the planning, because I know that. So my both the son, I have made a birth in the Mars Dasha. So Rahu will not trouble him. I can trouble them, but at least Rahu will should not trouble. So if anybody is following Rahu Dasha by birth, 2nd, 4th, and 6th, again it's a default settings.
Okay, so it it's will a good
boost
Dasha.
Good things. See, your good things lie somewhere else, no? Rahu will bring and give you fastest. So 2nd, 4th, and 6th Dasha, it is from the birth. But not so lucky, and if it appears as your birth Dasha, or if it has appeared 3rd Dasha, 5th Dasha, or 7th Dasha, then it has a say, then it will make you trouble. Because
so if it's your odd Dasha, if it comes first at the time of your birth,
yeah,
or it's your 3rd Dasha, or your 5th Dasha, or your, of course, 7th, which is
going to happen.
Yes.
So that's a, in Dasha, it is very clear, Rahu want to give result by taking others' result, and it will give. So, if he get a chance to give a good result, he'll be happy and you will be happy.
Correct.
If he, see, he is bound with the giving result. And if he, you have bound them to give him first Dasha, third Dasha, then he has to suffer it. So, people are suffering if the Dasha falls by birth. Either they born in the, let me clarify, they are born in the Rahu Dasha, either they born in the lunar Chandra Dasha, Moon Dasha. If Moon Dasha, then it will be the third. If they born in the Dasha of Venus, then Rahu Dasha will fall fifth. Right? And seventh, if they are born in the Mercury Dasha. So they people born in such a type of planet as a birth Dasha or such a nakshatra, we'll do nakshatra later on. So then if Rahu falls your first, third, fifth, seventh Dasha by birth, then remedy is the only solution. Either just wait that it turns go away and then good time will come.
So like you said before, so you have to urge the people to move forward to the next Dasha.
Just pushing. Regarding Gochar, now Gochar has a two aspect. We'll see. See, there is a difference between Dasha and Gochar. That will
speak. Gochar, which is transit.
Transit. So in transit, what happened? It's your say. You go and take the result of this. And there's obviously nobody will go to bring the pain. So in Rahu Dasha, what happens? Rahu, you will never welcome Rahu.
Yeah.
And Rahu doesn't want the welcome. He'll automatically turn and come back to you. Now what happens? That the bhav wise, from the house wise Rahu, we'll see later. First, let me explain the Rahu in the transit of the cycle. See, cycle means in foreign it is also called Rahu returns. Means again in the second time it appears, third time it appears. Now see the first cycle of Rahu by birth, it ends up the 18th, where Rahu will exactly appear at the Rahu.
Same place.
See Rahu, let me draw the attention that Rahu is the only planet who works simultaneously in Dasha and Gochar. How? Because when Rahu give in the Dasha, how many years Rahu Dasha is there? 18 years.
Correct.
And what is the transit of Rahu? 18 years.
18.
So if Rahu Dasha, whenever your Rahu Dasha start, at that point, Rahu stand at that position, at the end of the Rahu Dasha, you will be standing in the same position. That is why Rahu Dasha called a merry-go-round.
Okay.
It, 9 years it will accelerate you, and 9 years it will again come back to the rear position. So you will be moving towards a giant wheel and come back to the original place. So that's a
that
very
is
scary.
Such a thing.
Yeah.
Yes.
So what happens that the first cycle when Rahu completes, you turn 18. When you turn 18, entire world will give you the title of major. Become a major now. So that is the 18th age where all the people in the world think now you are capable of taking a decision. 18.
Yes,
so that is the 18th age where the Rahu will again come back. See in Gochar what happened there, whenever the planet enter upon their own house, means above their own position. Suppose Rahu to Rahu appears on 18, 36, 54, 72. Let's take up to 72. So from year 0 to year 18 is the first cycle.
Correct.
From 18 to 36 is the second cycle. 36 to 54 is his third cycle. And 54 to 72 is fourth cycle. Now same like a Dasha even odd. The cycle is also even out.
Okay.
So
cycle same also rule even applies out. Here as
yeah.
Well.
Now fourth cycle from 0 to 18, Rahu make you so much struggles. In 18, student will reach to the age of class of 12.
Mm-hmm.
12 standard, you know, it is a very
important year.
Important year where your career and entire things get changed. So that is the first cycle. Always Rahu in the first cycle because it touching all the house first time. Catching all the house first time.
Correct.
So that is why you become scary.
Mm-hmm.
But
you're
after
scared.
18, huh, you're scared. So after 18, what become? You become a courageous. So 18 to 36 is a Rahu main year. That's the second cycle. And it's a very good.
It's a good cycle.
People take too much risk between 18 to 36.
Correct.
Again, 36, what happened? He reached to his middle age of career. If we consider 70 as a career age, so he reached exit in the middle. So 36 to 54, again he will go back to the secure life rather than unsecure. That is third cycle. Third cycle again create the tension and anxiety because now you got a less time to expand and more time to work hard. So 36 to 54, again Rahu will make you problem. From 54 to 72, it's a fourth cycle. Now in the 54 age, you will also get settled. Your next generation also gets settled. So Rahu will least bother you.
Okay.
So Rahu's period from 18 to 36, those who are in the age of, you can say youth or the youngsters, there's so much of the Rahu courage,
yeah,
then daring. This all appears because of the Rahu's second cycle, and you get again power between 54 to 72 of the fourth cycle. So everybody in the transit, they have to see it the cycle wise.
Okay.
I don't find any people who are doing as a cycle wise.
Yeah.
They see where it's running, what is running. Every planet, Jupiter, Saturn, they all have their cycle, but that we discuss in other thing. First,
so
we
one question which is coming to my mind is that Rahu is right now in an odd sign, which is Leo.
Yeah.
But of course, it's being controlled by Jupiter as well.
Yeah, present it is.
So if it had been left alone, I think without Jupiter, it would have given worse results.
Yeah, yeah. That we are going to face after August, no? When the Jupiter will go
into
for one entire year. There will be an entire year. But what happens that by that time it will cross is half the way. As I told you, that half the way it will.
So it's already slowing down.
Slowing down. Nothing much.
So 9 months it goes up, 9 months it comes down.
Same pattern. Now considering Rahu's in each house, if you go ahead with each house as I then in the Saturn. Now Rahu, whenever enter in the first house, another chapter of your life will start.
This is in transit.
See, in birth, as I discussed with you, that whoever have a Rahu in the first house is his first birth as a human being.
Correct.
Same as whenever Rahu enter in your first house, a new chapter of your life will start.
Okay.
Marriage, child, new career, something.
New place, something, new career, something.
Your body will turn into the certain things which you have not done before. So your life will turn somewhat. At present you are doing certain things and then you divert to certain things. So whenever Rahu enter, wait till Rahu enter in your first house. I always give good guidance, because what happened, the Rahu runs reverse. Rahu runs reverse. So after second house it has jumped to first house.
Correct.
Not from 12 to 1.
Very true.
It is not from 12 to 1, it is from reverse way.
Yeah, second it moves retrograde.
Retrograde or reverse way.
Yeah.
So what happened, whatever you are lose, again you have to rebuild. Relation, money, whatever.
Okay.
So it is reverse, other way. So people also take the transit clockwise. No, it is anti-clockwise only. So it is anti-clockwise. So what happens, the Rahu whenever enter in the first house, after leaving your second house, that means now new chapter has to be introduced in your life.
But sir, it's an odd house, so will it give good results or bad results?
See, even an odd is to be seen as a cycle, not a house.
Okay. As a cycle as well.
As a cycle, that 0 to 18 years is the first cycle.
Okay.
Third cycle.
But first house when it appears,
yeah,
there's a change in your life.
Some drastic change, or your body will now turn back to the sun. See, many people totally, it is a transformation. It's the best word, is a transformation. Transformation means your entire change, that
360 degree.
Because your life now turn and need something new things in your life. So then it will turn to the 12th house. See, after first house it will not go to second house. So we'll also by moving we'll see the 12th.
Correct.
So when after first house when it entered to the second house, if you have not accepted any change in the first, nowadays be aware of loss, because you lose your direction.
It's expensed.
Yeah, as I already mentioned that Rahu in the 12th house, some big loss from the nature will occur.
Correct.
So here nature will make you suffer, that I given you a chance, why you have not turned your life?
Okay.
And if you turn, then nature will help you. So that is the best.
So this is abiding by the rules of Rahu's transit.
So one has to always see where his Rahu is there and where he is going to move. It is not always anti-clockwise, it is a clockwise. See, Rahu movement is always clockwise.
Correct. Right.
For world it is reverse, but for him it is
it's the right direction.
It's the right direction. So Rahu after 12, when it entered to the 11th house, so whatever loss, if you have not done anything, whatever loss you have suffered, now you are again new things, new desire will fulfill. As I told you that 11th house is
desire.
And that desire which you have not seek or which you have not dreamed before. So here whenever Rahu enters in the 11th house, your desire will fulfill. Because whatever loss has to be happened, it has happened. Whatever the nature has to taken, he has taken. Now it wants to give you something. So in 11th house, wait till it comes to 1st house or 11th house, so that any new thing will start working.
Okay.
After you gain the position, now when it entered to the 10th house, now power of name and fame. Now it is called power pack. As already I have said, 3, 6, 10, 11 is a good house for Rahu. Not only for the placement, it's also for the transit also. So in after fulfilling your desire, what happened? Your name, fame, recognition will become. So you explore to the world. Now your the world will explore. Name, fame, work, whatever area you are not concentrated, that area, that type of work, which all encounter nearby. So, 10th, so So 10, 11, both are the good position of Rahu. Some good and some bad also will happen.
Okay.
That's a nature.
Yeah, of course.
Always straight line, it has to break somewhere.
Yeah.
So in the ninth
house. Wave of
life.
Up and down.
So it is a life goal. So now whenever it is enter into the ninth house after completion, see after the growth there is a stability. See what happens? People get so much name, fame, then they become disappear. See whenever people reach to the top now, then they again go back to work.
Correct.
So in ninth house it says it's a house of transformation, traveling. Basically it is a house of traveling.
Mm.
If you don't travel means you have to change certain things.
Whether mentally or physically.
Either you have to change your habits, either you have to change your practice, daily practice, anything you have to change. Because ninth house is a change.
Mm.
So here you have to lots of traveling. Traveling means not physical you are moving. Something are moving around you.
Yeah.
So that is a traveling. Now after 9 when it enter to the 8th house, now again as a first house, here also you will get a new venture in your life. You will get a secret or some reward will be there in your life. Because the 8th Rahu always reveals some of the other secret. Either by, you can say that things which is already on the pipeline and not coming towards you, that will explode. And you will get the things which are already sailing, but you are not unable to concentrate on your side. So in the 8th, whenever Rahu is transiting, I don't know, very many people whenever it is transit to 8th house, they say that new fear will come. No, things will so drastically change.
Change.
As I told you that Mars and Rahu is an accident. Originally Kalpurus, it is a 8th, 8th is a Mars.
Correct.
So certain accidents, certain new things, certain unpredictable things will be going to start.
Yeah.
And all the unpredictable things are the secret of the life. You will not aware about this previously.
Very true.
So whenever it enter 8th house, you will find some secret. Some things will come to know, oh, I am practicing such a thing, but originally it is like that.
So but they fear Rahu in the 8th house. Dar lagega, I'll be scared, I'll have some accident.
Yeah, because
have
your
this,
acceptance was not there, no? Your acceptance was
but
not there.
But with the knowledge if we go, then we know which direction we have to
in
move.
In initial stage, I show you that you have no option but to follow the Rahu.
Yeah.
If you follow with this.
So we have to embrace him.
Yeah, if you always with the flow of the Rahu, Rahu wants to lead you to the certain things. From known to unknown things. All the astrologers are always with the unknown facts, secrets.
Yes.
Now when it is from 8 to 7, when it was now it is again a question house, people have so much force. Because you now got the secret.
Correct.
You got something new, which you are also not aware and people are also not aware. Mm. But now you got that precious thing. So now when the honey comes.
So honey bees will come.
So here 7th house, everybody will rush and attract you. So it is sometimes it is very difficult to handle such a crowd. And already in the house discussion also we have seen whenever it is a 7, it is very very the people will misguide you.
Misguide.
So here also I mentioned that the people will turn your things. Be patient and be careful. Who's your, who's not your, you are unable to decide, don't decide. So but you have to be very much conscious. Now after 7, if you have taken patience and conscious about your thing. Now 6, again try to cure your things. It will cure your things automatically. That is why in the 7th row I say wait. If you wait, then automatically by default setting in the 6th house, because 6 is the default setting house.
Correct.
For Rahu. So while it enter to the segment, whatever unwanted things and the things burden with you will all be removed.
So all the people that you attracted and
Either people,
disease,
problems, worries, whatever things will wipe out. So that is also a very good thing. Now after this, 5th house, again it is a bad house for Rahu because it will give you temptation to attract your past birth deeds. And you can't attract all the deeds at a time.
Okay.
So that is why I always make a precaution, if Rahu has place in 5th house, okay, you can incline towards the speculation, share, lottery, everything. But if Rahu transit on the 5th house, you know, it is transit on the
5th.
Yeah, because it's an illusion. It is an illusion that is created. You will feel that it is all are yours. You owe something from all. But no, that is wrong. You will be misguided. And your so many good deeds will remove from you. Because Rahu absorbs. Rahu absorbs all the negativity. So that is why whenever Rahu transit, your fifth house. See, there's a difference between transit in the Lagna and Moon. We have to see both the ways.
Both the ways.
Whatever
yes.
pass from your ascendant will have a physical effect, and whatever pass from the Moon, from
will have a mental effect.
Moon Kundli, it have a mental effect. So that was the main thing, that fifth house, as I said. And that time, if your Rahu is in fifth house, don't interfere in the matter of your child also.
Okay.
Don't force them, oh, you marry, or you change your life, or you don't. Because that will also wrong. You are attracting your good deeds with your child, and you have absorbed so many things.
Absorbing it, that nothing will remain.
And if he failed, because your decision ultimately failed.
Correct.
And that failure will be faced by him.
Yes.
So if anybody is passing fifth Rahu, they should avoid taking decision about child.
Okay.
Now many parents said, if we don't take, who will take? And let him ask him, you want to do this or not this? See, sometime what happens, in Delhi, I don't know, but in Bombay, we have an astrologer on the street. They have parrot. Here, I don't know.
Yeah, we go to Rani, old Delhi, if you go, then they have them there.
So, being an astrologer, people think that I don't know so much thing, but I still sometimes use that luck.
Achha.
You go to that parrot wala astrologer.
Adi, is it true?
Yeah, I many time tested.
Okay.
See what happened, whenever I got some confusion, no, I immediately stick to the Prashna Kuli and I say, yeah, my answer. I got my answer. But if you want to check your answer with
double
the nature,
check it. Yes.
If you want to check, if it is a drastic change,
mm-hmm.
big decision, you go to nature. Nature will not reply immediately. Nature will reply by its nature own creation.
Mm-hmm.
And nature creation is a bird, animals, always.
Okay.
So I go to Parrotwala and sit, and I say, remove one chin.
Yeah.
So he'll remove and he'll open and say, aapka ye oti ote vada vada vada.
Okay.
You'll find your answer.
So that is a very big secret you have revealed.
Why people?
That when you
know.
Are in doubt.
Yeah.
And when you feel that you may be.
You reach half the way.
Half the way. And you are in
yeah.
doubt whether I should be taking this step forward or not.
What is the nature sign?
Sign. What is the sign of nature?
Yeah.
And
that is why the omens has came, no?
Yeah.
Good omens and bad
good
omens.
Omen and bad omen.
What you see. Because that nature creates. So, if you don't find anything, then go to such a person. Don't see. Human interfere maybe with the nature it can manipulate. But not the
not,
animal.
Not so one very quick question in the middle of this transit is, which bird or animal is Rahu?
Rahu is a snake.
Snake
is a Rahu.
Yes.
See, it is called snake head is a Rahu and tail
that's
is a
tail,
Ketu.
Yeah.
That is why Rahu and Ketu, that is Kala Sarpa. Why Kala Sarpa?
Kala
is a Ketu. Kala is a Ketu. That is why you can't able to see and change your Kala. That is Ketu.
Correct.
And Sarpa means Rahu. So that is a, see, even we are speaking Rahu Ketu, but it is Ketu Rahu.
Okay. Yeah.
Because Ketu is bigger than Rahu. Rahu is a small part.
Small
part. So what happens that, that is why many people get a dream of snake. And people call me that I get a dream of snake.
Unscared, what is
that? Yeah. That means some of your ancestors are remembering you. Just do something good for your ancestors. Or sometimes that happens. That you internally also, by not awaring, curse them. What is my grandfather has done about it? So nature will again come back and reply. So one has to be careful. Many people said, if I see snake, that means I am going to get an inheritance. See, inheritance not always in the terms of money. That is a sanskar and
your ancestors.
Yeah, remember your ancestor. Do the good things of the day. So whenever
sir, in Chinese religion or
yeah.
in Chinese race, they have one full month of ancestral month.
Okay.
And then in those days, they burn money, they keep food. They burn money which they are saying is going to our ancestors.
Yes, yes.
And they're keeping food outside their house and putting agarbatti and all that for the ancestors. It's a huge festival. It's called the Moon Festival.
Mm-hmm.
And it goes on for the whole month.
See, we also have 15 days.
We also have 15 days. Absolutely.
By which we remember. See, why Pitru Paksha also created? Because that time, sun is very near to the earth. and Sun we believe is our ancestor.
Correct.
So that is why there was two heat during that month.
Yeah.
October heat, we speak about October heat. That is Pitru Paksha, whereby Sun, and Sun is your soul. Or the soul or the ancestors.
Or ancestors, your father.
Yeah, father, forefather, and this. They have come to the near, so you have exchange with them. So whatever you
so they're so close that whatever you do for them, they can receive.
I think you might be remember about my clue of Saturn lottery.
Yes.
So
you said you to check whether your Saturn is good or bad, you should buy lottery.
For Rahu also there is a testing.
There
is again the secret whether one should reveal or not. So for Rahu what happens that you think about anything. Think that extreme that you are unable to do.
Okay.
First you have to see whether your Rahu is powerful or not. Think that think the things which is next to impossible for you. Suppose
I want to be in New York today.
Or you within a month or
within 15 days.
Days
I want to be in New York.
And bind with the time. Bind with the time that within a 15 days I want to be with this. I want this because I have tested 2-3 times and without my this intention it has created. So that is why I am now very much
because your Rahu is well placed.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that is why one should not take a risk.
Okay.
So now what happened that if you desire okay, within 15 days or you desire that with somebody's your relation is spoiled. Example, because that is a common thing in the India or entire world that your relation is spoiled with some person. You give yourself time that within a 15 days I will meet or he will meet you. Now it is next to impossible. Because you have turned your face.
Absolutely.
You have turned your face. But if your Rahu is powerful, Rahu is a nature. If your Rahu is powerful, this news will reach to the person and some of the other compelling thing will happen that either you have to face or either they will call. It happens. So think some extreme things
secret,
with a time bar. Within 1 month, don't time bar for a life. See, we always give 15 or 1 month because that's a lunar cycle.
Okay.
And Rahu is a best server serve to the moon.
He's a slave of the moon.
So either 15 days or 1 month, you give the period of 1 month or the 15 days. And within 15 days, he should call me. This should be happen to me. This. And if it happens, then Rahu is very much pleased with you. Not happen, that means Rahu is not favoring you. Now you need a remedy for Rahu. It's an easy way. For the easy. That is why somebody comes to me and do ask for certain things. No, I give him some remedy. Do this for 15 days, and if you find some changes, see while doing now he put his intention also. I am doing this because I am getting this. So he's remembering these things. No, tapping. He's tapping the things.
So the energy is reaching the other side.
Secret. So we have reached to 5th house. This is 5th house. That is why we go back.
4th house now.
So whenever it enters to the 4th house, there will be no pleasure. Again, it is not a good house. Whatever pleasure, see, you will have the pleasure, but you will not get a time to enjoy that pleasure. If Rahu is placed in 4th house, there will be no pleasure for the entire life. You have material, but no pleasure. But when it transit, at least don't buy a new house. Otherwise, that building will never construct.
Oh, I see.
You see the halfway constructed.
Half built,
because some of the other, either they have constructed on certain mural, or either somebody has purchased whose Rahu has entered in the 4th house. Or not also the builder. Builder's Rahu will enter in the 4th house, he is not able to construct.
Okay.
So, whenever there is a 4th Rahu, avoid a new pleasure. Avoid new things, new venture, new things in your life. Otherwise, your pleasure some or the other way. Then you have to make so much good to turn it to the positive. And that will take 1.5 years. Again.
Correct. By then it will transit into the 3rd house.
Yeah. And 3rd house, again default setting.
Correct.
Nature will automatically repair this.
Yes.
So, if nature are going to give you, why you are putting your human efforts in 4th house? What is the waiting period? 1.5 year only? You are waiting for your house for 30 years, 35 years, 40 years. No 1.5 years till you can pay. But people doesn't have pleasure. Patience. So whenever it is a 4th house, don't purchase a new house. Don't even purchase a small thing of your pleasure.
Okay.
Like a mobile. If you purchase a mobile, it gives you pleasure. AC, whatever the small pleasure. some of the other way, everybody will enjoy it. Your phone will be always hanged, your phone will be always a virus attacked, theft, anything will happen.
So no wonder all my phones are getting lost.
My day started in 4th row. So now whenever it enters to the 3rd house, by 4th it will come to the 3rd house. Again it will repair everything which has created bad in the 4th house. So for Rahu you have no option but to wait for the default house setting. Until unless it reaches to the default setting, it will again become a normal. Because between 2 house it will excited. Again it will peace and again it will excite. So whenever it is in 3rd, do whatever you want to do, because he is with you, Rahu is with you, and he will always support you. And when Rahu support you, then nobody
no
will
else can
try to face you, because
yeah,
they will not see you, they will see behind you, oh, there is a Rahu. That is why, see, Ketu is your shadow. In my Ketu video I said your shadow,
yeah.
And I have given one secret in this, that the Avichit Murat you have to pray. And for Rahu also, see, Rahu is also shadow, both are the Chayagraha. There is a one time comes in the entire day, some between 12:20 to 1 o'clock.
When the sun is right on
yeah.
top of us.
So what happened? Your sun exactly touched the crown chakra, is
yeah.
here is the crown chakra, and your shadow will be always under your feet.
Correct.
Yeah.
So Rahu and Ketu.
So what happened? That will not pressurize you. And whatever wish, desire, whatever you do, it will come immediately. So that is a very much secret also, again it is in my Ketu, all the detail I have given, that whenever you want to make anything, see why people are asking with the one person who also affect under the planet, ask to the nature, no?
Correct.
Nature will give you, whatever, see now it is a reading spec, but in 2000 I have a long distance spec, but I am very scared about wearing the, this, it will become loose and you have to depend always. So I have started for 2 months, I stand 12:20, 12:25, 12:40, I stand behind under the sun, and I wish that I don't want a spec. Then after 1.5 months, when I visit to my optician, he said, you were smiling, number chale gaye aapke, shayad kache honge. Are kache kya honge, I have made practice for it.
Wow.
So whatever you want from
sir,
the
every
nature,
day for how much time did you stand in the sun?
That is also a big question. Somebody has asked me, sir, 40 minutes I stand behind the sun, my whole feet was burning. Well, who told you
in
to
summer?
Stand?
And
who told you to stand? Just see, to make a wish, how many time it takes? 2 minutes?
Yeah.
4 minutes? You don't have to spray like no.
For so long.
Just pray.
Please go there.
Sun will pass from all the chakra. Sun
it is so
pass.
Strong at that.
Yeah, immediately it will pass. It's a UV, ultraviolet.
Yeah, very true.
Touch. And touch to your soul, wherever the soul is there, and clean all chakra and fill with the energy. You know the teeth filling root canal, same.
Straight like inside.
Straight inside it goes, and then command start. Now I will want this thing. And tapping is registering, and many times say tapping is registering. So whenever you tap, that Rahu will give me good result, Rahu will give, it will give. But what you are doing or the general people are doing, no, Rahu will worst me, Rahu will
yeah.
make me.
So don't be scared, be his friend.
Yeah. You have any option?
No.
Then become a friend, no?
Absolutely.
So now is the left is the third
second
is the
house.
Default setting. Now second house, again is a house of shaky. Many things will turn, new relation will enter and old relation will move. So if the old relation are moving by itself, don't try to pick them. They will make you problem. See, some bodies are going from
your
life.
So what you're saying is, in the second house when there's a transit,
yeah.
some relations are leaving you at that time. Those who are not good for you,
yeah.
they're leaving you. Don't try to hold them back.
Yeah. Otherwise
they'll
come.
Create problems.
Now Rahu will turn.
Okay, the Rahu.
You have to go with the
Rahu.
You can't go empty with the Rahu. Or sometimes it happens that you have given money to someone and they will not return. Why they are not returning? Because you have to give them.
Anyway, from past life.
Yeah, past life. Rahu is ultimately a past life. So what happened? You have given them, they have not returned. Now, if you are behind him, what will happen? You are behind a small portion and your
Rahu is going to get spoiled.
So that is why Rahu, whenever enter in the second house, something will turn. Either your relation will turn or some of the money will turn. wait, because once it will again enter in the first house, again it will leave. But please try to remove the negativity clutters from your house, because second is your house also. So if try to remove the unwanted things, and you are behind the unwanted things. So it is a good transit of this. So by this, I think we have covered this all this planet. Now all the house. Now on the planet, the small ride of the planet also will finish. If Rahu is transiting over your sun, it happens, no? With the house, it transits to planet also. So whenever Rahu is transiting towards your above your sun.
So sun is placed in the first house. And Rahu transit is, for example. In any house, and Rahu is in that same house, in Aries. So,
when it enters the same sign, go overlapping it and then remove. So whenever Rahu is transiting over the sun, that means your father is going to affect. Now you are no more father, your elder person whose act as a father will go suffer, and somebody
will suffer.
Rahu will suffer, and Rahu is a father.
Son
is a father. So your father or Pitrutulya, who's as like a father, who's carrying it, or your name, some or the other will suffer. So don't try to involve in certain activities, otherwise your name will spoil. So whenever it is passed from sun, this free effect will be immediately. And immediately effect will be you lose your confidence. So again is the confidence. Sun is the confidence. So see, whenever someone's father leave, immediately your confidence level went down. And you feel that you lost everything. Why people remove the hair? To show the society that now no protection. And why you open this? Because now nature will give the energy. That is why they remove the hair in their mouth. Everything has its own meaning. Whenever it is passed from the moon, sun as a father, moon as a mother, or some emotional person to whom you have an emotional relation, sometimes to sister, having very emotional relation, your good friend, having an emotional relation. See, here one has to understand by emotions that without him, you can't stay. You always like him, company or everything. And mother, ultimately it's a mother. Or some of your thoughts become dry.
Yeah.
It also happens, some of your thoughts also will become dry. Or you might become some dry. Now you're feeling somewhat dry because Rahu absorbs, no? Now it will take some more years to develop that feelings. So mother or your mood will somewhat affect you. If it is passing on the Mars, together with the Mars is an accident. You passing over the Mars, that means some incidents will happen which is no, you have no desire. Because Mars desire, Rahu is a higher version of desire. So both will link. Now both will link. And things will happen, certain things which you have not think before. It might be an accident, a road accident or anything, or might be something drastic change.
Good or bad?
Good or bad, but normally it is bad. Now there is a planet, both the planet, minus, minus, plus.
Yeah.
That equation plays.
Yeah.
So that also, and again, if you are buying to purchase a property during that period, try to hold for 1.5 years. Now, about the Buddh, whenever it is passing towards the Mercury. See, Mercury and Rahu is also related because in Virgo sign, Rahu gets own sign. And in the Gemini, it is exalted. Both the Mercury sign is comfortable for the Rahu. So Rahu is very much comfortable when it passes over the Mercury. But majority people doesn't get this result because Mercury always sit with the Rahu, Surya.
Sit
on the sun.
And sun and Rahu don't get along.
So even though Mercury won't, that is why those are lucky who are not associated with either Jupiter, Venus is together or alone Mercury.
Or Venus is together.
Alone Mercury.
Okay.
And if the Rahu passed, so Rahu will feel the things. Intelligent and high intelligent things will feel. So it is a good thing. Faster decision, booster. It will boost the decision.
Boost your intelligence.
Yeah, boost the intelligence. Now on the Jupiter, whenever Rahu enters upon the Jupiter, again same result of your second house. You will either lose some relation or either you will lose some money. So that is also not the right time or right direction to do any new venture. Particularly no social function, means if your child is going to get married, you are also planning to have your child. Likewise also, okay, so right, that will absorb, because Guru is very giant, it covers so many houses. So you have to hold your future or growth plan in this Jupiter. Now Mars, Venus. When Rahu passed with the Venus, what I have written, no traveling, no new pleasure, avoid traveling, that will be always discomfort. Your ticket, even though confirmed, somebody will come and occupy and you have to fight. Or otherwise you will lose the train, lose the, and during the traveling or during your pleasure hours, you will find some of the other people will interfere with you. That is also whenever Venus pass. So that is why Venus and Mercury also sit together and Rahu pass, one good and one bad result, so you can't accumulate. As I told you that Venus and Rahu together is a vikar, higher version of addiction.
Addiction, addiction.
And now there's the last balance is the Saturn.
Saturn.
When Saturn is placed and Rahu comes over this, so two extremity goes simultaneously. One very slow, one very hyper. Slow and hyper. So what happens that your Saturn is very well placed, but Rahu is a visitor here. Mm-hmm. So what happens, things will go slow, but you try to do something, accelerate the things, and it goes double loss.
Okay.
So that is why Shani Rahu is always called the Pitru Dosh, Srapit Dosh, it is Srapit Dosh. Even if Rahu is transiting over Saturn, you have to take extra care, because two extreme power going to clash each other. One slow and one very excited.
Yeah.
So whenever Saturn, Rahu is passing over the Saturn sign, so no change in work. Many people ask about the career.
Mm-hmm.
So if people are changing their career, during the Saturn, whenever the Saturn is placed and Rahu transit over it, they should always have a patience. Otherwise, that will be a drastic change. You will lose previous job also, and you are not able to take the new job also. There will be a drastic change between these two. And your work some or the other way affected. See what happens, many times people for development or expansion, they purchase a new machinery.
Correct.
But at that time, if Rahu is transiting over Saturn, what happens, new machinery will not fit and your old labor will create problem.
Okay.
See.
Yeah. So you have to adjust to it.
Yeah, so then what happens, your new machinery is scrapped and your old workers run away. So that
so you should not, it's not a time to change,
expansion, anything. You don't have to change your pace. Mm-hmm. You can see the pace. You have to do with the, your pace.
Just go as you are going.
See, Rahu is very much, you say, it's a conspiracy type or the surrender. He will always incline to pull you. And if you turn to him, see, he will always give here one noise and here another noise. Here he'll say, go, nobody is there. You know, there's one, in our law, the one word comes as a cryptomania. It's a stealing.
Cryptomania.
It's a stealing. What happened that temptation, and majority it has found that the well-to-do and that people only have this tendency.
Right.
So what happened, they can't stop. They know that everybody is seeing or the camera, still they steal. So that is a temptation, Rahu. Take, nobody is giving. In my Ketu video, I say that Ketu always stand in front of Rahu and let the things to be done. Rahu will tempt you, do, nobody is seeing, go. And once you do, Ketu will write, he has done this. And one or the other day, you are going to suffer. So that is why you don't have to, you have to always keep a balance and pace between these two planets.
Okay.
If you don't pace, because you are in between these two.
Yeah.
Ketu is on another end. Rahu is on another end, there is a 180 degree distance, and in between is you.
Yeah.
So one will draw you and one will make you face. So better, no action, it's a better action. So by Gochar and Transit, it is very small thing, but you have to see the cycle, you have to see Dasha when if it is appear in the things. See, many people ask from where the detail of Rahu to be studied. I advise them, you read Yavan Jatak. It's a very good book for Rahu.
Okay.
Yavan Jatak, because it is basically written for entire Rahu. There are so many scholars who have done research for Rahu also. But Yavan Jatak basically written from the angle of Rahu. Because Parashar doesn't believe on the Rahu. He has never mentioned anything about the Rahu. He has said Yavan. He has mentioned Rahu, not a Rahu. But he has mentioned as a two node, or he has mentioned as a Yavan. So Yavan Jatak is a book whereby you can get the extra knowledge of Rahu. So that
so one last one. What about Rahu going about over Ketu?
Yeah, that's the exact 9 year cycle.
Correct.
So what happened? Both will change each side.
Oh, Ketu will go up?
Ketu will go on
Ketu,
down.
Okay, okay. So it's the same effect.
Again, both will charge. That is why I said that 9 years. 9 years.
Oh, you're so you're completely up.
See what happens that you see in metro or in our local train, what happens that who was driver, no, he'll turn and go back, and who was in backside, he'll come as a driver.
Oh,
same as
awesome.
It will be reverse.
Yeah.
So what happens? They will again see. You know, there's a worm, earthworm.
They move from both directions.
And this also, no, the same Rahu and
okay,
Ketu.
Okay.
So that is why it's a sub. But snake doesn't move both the
yeah.
side, but there's an earthworm
yeah.
move both the side. If you cut also, they both will run.
Yes.
So that is a one will change to another place and another will change into this place.
Yeah.
See, ultimately they have to get the support of each other.
Right.
So they will just exchange their flow. Nothing else. So that is also one of the sides. So that is a half age. You see nine. Where your primary education complete and you enter to the secondary? 9.
Correct.
Right? So that was halfway change.
Yeah.
18 entire your secondary.
Your full change.
It is a half change.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
27. Normally people get married around 27.
Correct.
Halfway. 36 complete cycle.
Yeah.
27 and halfway.
Correct.
Then after this, this is a 45. Again the halfway. 36 and 54 is the middle age of 45.
Right.
Many people slowly change certain things
yeah.
in 45.
So you go up till 45, you may also come down, or the other way around.
So Rahu, it's a big chakra. We don't have to come in the chakra of the Rahu Ketu.
Yeah.
See, for Rahu and Ketu, no, I always see, whenever I see Rahu Ketu, no, see what happens that again there's a law of physics where the intention goes, energy flows.
Correct.
So if you are seeing, see some, suppose you will ask me why my Rahu is giving me problem. So I have to see Rahu. I have to see Rahu in horoscope. I have to see Rahu in Namas. I have to see Rahu in Dasha. So everywhere I am attracting Rahu.
Correct.
And so
very
one
true.
Precaution has to be taken. If even though you divert me, then see now my Rahu is giving problem. I'll say no, no, it is a Saturn. Why I should encourage your Rahu?
Correct.
So that precaution all the astrologer has to take. And see, in Rahu Parashar, Parashar Muni has already written, those who are in this line, their Rahu will charge. And to
because
discharge.
Always looking at what is, why is the difficulty and
yeah.
why is.
And difficulty is second name is Rahu.
Correct.
So after attracting so many time of the Rahu, something drastic also attract to you also.
Correct.
So that is why Parashar Muni has said, those who are the astrologer should do the good. Deeds. Always you have to
okay.
do good deeds. Or the, he said that the Japa Mahamrityunjay or name the Vishnu Sahasranam. Why this is all precautionary measures has given? Because you are also touching that planet. See, example of the doctor. See, suppose you have some worm. What happened? He will repair this and immediately wash his hand, no?
Correct.
Do you wash your hand after seeing the horoscope?
No. You have to wash your soul actually.
Uh-huh.
Your
means,
whole, your inside.
You have to cure yourself.
You're
curing it by letting the things of Rahu.
Oh, I see. So that is why, whenever I am studying astrology or I have seen any charts and all that, I feel like meditating.
Yeah. Because you have to.
I feel like doing something which
yeah.
will make, which will calm me down.
You accelerate your Rahu, no? So you need some or the other.
Yeah.
And that is why best mood is butter. See, if I have taken some energy from you, you give me some energy. So it will butter. That is why this practice of, see previously it was a butter, they give rice and things
correct,
to the
correct.
Astrologer. Now they take in the consideration of money.
Money.
But those who are only researcher and doing without money, I don't know. How they are
because you are taking
Rahu.
Their karma in a way
yeah.
also.
And in exchange you are not taking
you're not
anything.
Giving anything.
See in Reiki, Pradin healing, I also heard that you have to give at least thanks also.
Yeah.
If you are not paying anything, you have to give thanks. Okay,
thanks.
Thank you, you have cured me or things.
Yeah.
Then things happens.
Okay.
So that is why those who are not a professional
yeah.
should do something for curing. Otherwise, I don't know the Rahu will lead to what level. But all the professionals, those who are doing very good, they have a very good name. They all Rahus are supporting.
Yeah.
There's only a Rahu. Many people think about as a Jupiter. Jupiter is ka acha hoga, so he good astrologer. No, Rahu. Because he has collected so many pieces of Rahu from all this chart. And
that
now,
has been accelerated and boosting it.
Oh.
Now he is utilizing that energy for himself. So I believe that Rahu has touched all the corners. He has touched all the corners.
Yeah.
Right?
So this is a very, very extensive three series video that we have made on Rahu.
Yeah.
I think it was worth utilized.
At least viewers should always give the comments.
Sir, ek baat to aapki bolni padegi that the viewers are going crazy about you. And I think I would also like to say that you're an astrologer, you are professionally practicing astrology,
yeah.
And you get a lot of, you see horoscopes as well, you're a professional astrologer.
Yeah.
So sir, what is the way of getting in touch with you?
Email, best.
Email.
Because calls, what happens, so many call comes, so it is very disturbing. In between some consultation, if the call comes, my intention also break. So basically, if anybody gives any reports or the inquiry into my email, that will be better. And I have created web page also.
Yeah.
In Facebook, I created DM Astrology.
So DM is for your name, Dharmesh Mehta.
Yeah, Dharmesh Mehta and
okay.
Astrology.
Okay.
So anybody will type this DM Astrology in Facebook, he'll get all the updates of this.
So DM is one word and astrology is the second word.
Yeah, second word. Yeah. DM Astrology.
But sir, that is a place that we can go and check. Aapki, what is your email ID? Sir, ekbari, I think you really need to do us this favor so that people can get in touch with you.
See, my email ID is also same, DM Astrology, it's a single word, then number1@gmail.com. That's a very easy. My channel name is also DM Astrology.
Yes.
My Facebook page is also DM Astrology. And my email also dmastrology1@gmail.com. So people can always contact me.
Thank you, sir, so much. Welcome to Delhi again. And I hope your flight back to Bombay is going to be safe and tranquil.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Thank you.